What is up? We are back for another team builder. This one is for the CPL. Going into week five with a 2-3 record. So really need this one to get back into playoff race. And this week we are going to go up against Eric, coach of the Denver Rapidash. So I'll just get right into this. So his team, very interesting team, especially for a matchup against my team. First off, have Mega Manectric. Why I think it is most top three, I definitely see coming. If he does not bring them, he is a madman. But other than that, other things can change, but Mega Manectric is really good this matchup. Outspeeds my entire team. Can easily Volt Switch if I do not bring Claydol. Get that fast momentum going with the Intimidate. Really useful since my team is mainly physical attackers. As well as Overheat, which blows back my grass types, which resist electric. So does a lot of damage, as well as gets great momentum while lowering my attack power, which is what I mainly rely on with this team. Then we have Zydog, which also outspeeds my entire team, except for Pirouette form of Meloetta. But that would require me to get off a Relic Song with that. Thinking it might be a Scarf set to outspeed a Zard-X after it gets a Dragon Dance up, if he is really fearing that blown away his team. Could very well be Choice Banded with Extreme Speed to do that trick as well. It's Thousand. Whatchamacallit move does not get reduced by grassy terrain, so won't have to fear bringing that. It could very well be like a Life Orb or a Leftover set with Coil, which would be kind of hard to break, depending on spread. But that could be taken advantage of by Ditto, so least likely of the three sets to be brought of Choice Banded and Choice Scarf. Next up, Arcanine. Arcanine is probably his best wall to Mega Zard X. With the most damaging move I could probably do would be Earthquake if grassy terrain is not up, or Outrage if grassy terrain is up, and after Intimidate could easily eat that up. Could very well run a Morning Sun set for recovery to whittle down those Zard-X. Toxic on that set as well. Flare Blitz, Close Combat, and Wild Charge could bring for him. Could very well be a Scarfed offensive set with those moves as well as Close Combat. Basically blows back almost everything on my team in one shot, if not then two. Next up, we are getting into the more flexible part of his team, where it could come, it might not come, depending on what he wants to do. Keldeo, even though I do have those two grass types, it outspeeds them. Could very well set up Calm Minds. It is his Super Z-mon user, so can use status moves, but will probably be like Icium if it is brought. Specs does a number on my team. Don't really have the best switch-ins for Specs Keldeo. And it is quite a threatening mon. Could be run physical with Swords Dance. Believe it gets a release. I know other Sacred Horses get a release. So Swords Dance up and Blowfang's my grass types away with Arrowless, if it is run physical. And yeah, kind of a problem for my team. Once my grass type is gone. Next up, Gramble, another great defensive check. Probably his best answer to Gyarados, with the Intimidate coming off of that. So basically, with those triple Intimidators, this is kind of going to be a hard matchup for me since most of my mons, like I said, for our physical attackers. Can even do decently well against Zard-X, with Earthquake on it. Could run. I think it gets Thunder Punch. If not, then it definitely gets Thunder Fang, which can blow back Gyarados. So probably his best wall for Gyarados. Also helps deal with Tyranitar. And yeah. Another Intimidator could cycle through his Intimidators who weaken. Ooh, my team. Next up we have Mandibuzz. Mandibuzz is there for hazard removal. If he is like running Scarfers and whatnot, he does not want me setting up Sticky Webs to slow down those Scarfers. Doesn't want Sticky Webs up to slow down that Mega Main so that it is slower than things such as my Zard-X, as well as that Psyduck. So probably best way is with Defog on Mandibuzz. He could bring Dawnfang instead as a defensive wall. However, Dawnfang, I feel, kind of gets wrecked by Galvantula more than Mandibuzz. Mandibuzz at least gets Roost, gets Brave Bird, and has way better Spideff than Dawnfang does. Kind of a toss-up though. Dawnfang could be brought instead for Rocks and Rapid Spin. Rocks are kind of useful if Zard has yet to Mega, as well as against the Gyarados. Earthquake is nice as well as that Sturdy. Could easily run Gunshot for the Boolu, could run Knock Off. But I feel like bringing Mandibuzz with Foul Play is better for him than bringing Dawnfang, because of, like I said many times in previous videos, I do have that dual grass, which is quite nice offensively against bulky teams with bulky ground types and bulky waters, which are usually the bulky types on teams. Next up, Kartana, probably least likely to come. Maybe replace Caldeo. It is another one. It is a offensive Z move user. Could try and take advantage of Tapu Bulu's grassy terrain with it. Set up a Swords Dance, can blow things back. So if I do see it, is definitely going to be a Z move user, most likely with Swords Dance, and then Leaf Blade, Sacred Sword, and some kind of third move, probably with Phytonium Zed to make sure to be able to take out that Zard-X. Probably third move would be like Smart Strike. And yeah. Be Without a sword stance low, it kind of struggles to even pick up Okos against Mons on my team. So that's why I kind of don't have it up there. Already explained the Donphan, Chinchino. Chinchino could possibly come fast. I think King's Rock is banned in this league. So I can't skill link flinch me to death with King's Rock. But nice and skill link fast, Bullet Seed and Rock Blast are quite useful for my team. Rock Blast will make sure Sash Galvantula goes down. Useful for the Gyarados. Bullet Seed is nice for Claydol, as well as if I bring Bulu with Grassy Terrain, that would get a boost. Kind of struggles though with walls like Bulu, Tyranitar, Cobalion, Delmise, Garbodor. Can't really beat them. Then the next two could see Ninetales coming by itself, but it most likely come in the pair with Alolan Sandslash for that Slush Rush. If he is banking on my heavy grass presence, he will bring that. Probably most likely set up Rovial turn one. Probably won't care if it goes down, because then he can go straight into Alolan Sandslash, which is another one of his Z move users. Probably most likely set up a Sword Stance and then sweep my team with the combination of Earthquake and Icicle Crash. Basically demolishes my entire team, and then also Iron Head. Those three moves basically take out my entire team. So most likely we'll see them as a pair. And then we have Chestnut, probably not likely to come. It's set up fodder for my Gyarados, set up fodder for my Zardex. Doesn't do well against Galvantula, as hazard stacking goes. Offensively, grass and fighting aren't all that good against me. Fighting would really only be there for Tyranitar and maybe Cobalion, and Glaceon. And grass is really only there for Claydol. Also technically Tyranitar, but that is just doubling down with the typing of fighting and grass. So probably not likely going to see that coming. Don't expect it to come. So let us get into my team. First off, bring in forgot to nickname this. Honestly, its nickname is Silly Putty. Might lead off with Scarf Ditto. Depending on what his team is, get a good scout in. And yeah. See what kind of set he has. Also helps me get up rocks. As well as gives me a form of hazard removal if he brings Defog on that Mandibuzz or Rapid Spin on that Donphan. Will also outspeed Sandslash and the Hail, which is nice. My other possible lead option is going to be on Spider Galvantula. It is enough speed to outspeed the Arcanine, most likely gonna use this as a Sash Leap. Probably not gonna run on Nerf. Going to run Swamp for the bug boost. Bug buzz. Yeah, Sticky Web to slow things down like that Mega Manectric, like the Psyduck, like possibly Scarfed Arcanine. Slow down that Keldeo, slow down that Cartano, slow down Alolan Ninetales, slow down Sandslash and the hail, slow down that Chinchino, so my offensive threats can't pick them off. Volt Switch is there for momentum. Hidden Power Ice is mainly there for Psyduck, since it is kind of a problem for my team. And Bug Buzz is there for hard hitting stab, also blows back that Cartana, as well as goes past subs if he tries to sub up on me, and is very nice. Next up, I am bringing an Assault Vest. Almaz. This also, for some reason, doesn't have his nickname of Davy. Davy the Dalmise, Assault Vest, Rabbit Spin, Anchor Shot, Power Whip, Knockoff. This helps with things. It allows me to take a hit from Mega Manectric, which is kind of a problem for my team. Helps me get rid of hazards if he chooses to bring them, which I am kind of fearing. Helps me knock off items such as scarves, choice bands, choice specs, leftovers, which are kind of a pain for my team. Power Whip gives me massive damage on the Keldeo, as well as Psyduck. Helps with Donphan if he brings that as his removal. Anchor Shot is real nice for the Gramble, helps with Alolan Ninetales, and it helps with the Alolan Sandslash. So, very useful to have that Steel Taping. Next up, I am bringing Captain Cold. First time bringing Captain Cold, Glaceon, Chapelberry, Snowcloak. If he does bring Hail, I am not breaking Invasion Clause because I'm not the one bringing Hail to get that Invasion boost. With this attack stat, should be able to OKO the Psyduck. Supposedly, if it has some HP investment, it is not an OKO. Frostbust gets guaranteed crits. Helpful for that Mana Buzz, and helpful very much so since my special attack is not invested, but with that base 130, don't really need it. Hidden Power Fighting helps blow back that Alolan Sandslash. What else was it for? I think it was mainly for the Alolan Sandslash since Frostbath does more damage otherwise. And Mirror Coat, it's mainly there for catching things such as a special fighting move coming off that Keldeo, maybe if it's locked into Hydro Pump, useful for that. Useful for catching the Ninetales with some damage. Maybe Manectric if it doesn't go for a fire move and instead just goes for the Volt Switch. And yeah. Mainly there for the ice shard damage to pick things off, such as the Zygarde, and get some damage on Mandibuzz. also helps with Zydog if it tries to be a coil set. Frostbite. Oh wait, no, never mind. That's physical defense, but helps with Calm Mind Calcio. Trying to hopefully catch him off guard. I was deliberating between Mirror Coat and Aurora Veil, but if he does not bring Alolan Ninetales, then that move slot is useless if I bring Aurora Veil, so I decided on Mirror Coat. Next up, I am bringing King Arthur the Megazord X, Roost Will with Fire Punch Dragon Claw. This does not outspeed Arcanine. The speed investment, I believe, is that after Sticky Web's Mega Metric is going to be slower than it. Dragon Claw and Fire Punch. Well, this Roost. This is going to be a more bulky set. With this set, Specs Keldeo, if it is timid, will not be able to two-shot me. Will-O-Wisp is there to weaken damage coming off of that Gramble, off of that Psyduck, and whittle things down. And Fire Punch and Dragon Claw are all the damaging moves I need. I decided to, with this HP and Spadef investment, this maximizes my Spadef that I wanted to go for. It also helps wall the Mega Manectric, which otherwise with Fire and Electric does a number on my team. That is mainly why I am bringing Spadef. Megazord X is because of the threatening power of that Mega Mane. Mega Mane does not beat this Zard X at all. Unless for some reason it is running like maybe HP Ground. And even then, I think, if I remember my damage calcs correctly, Megazord X should still be able to 1v1 it unless I bring it in as Regazard X on rocks, which I have my Dalmise to spin it away. Last but not least, my kind of all-in wincon is Gary the Gyarados. Arcturium Zed, Moxie, Flamethrower, Bounce, Dragon Pulse, or Dragon Dance, and Waterfall. Once again, enough speed to outspeed Mega Mane after it gets slowed down by Sticky Webs, as well as after a Dragon Dance, I will outspeed it. So if webs do not stay up, I can still outspeed it if it does not start in on me. Not running EQ on it, even though that would be better for Mega Mane. Is because of that Kartana. I need something to hit that Kartana. Don't want it to be some kind of subset to beat me once Flying Zed is used, if he is expecting that with Bounce. Flamethrower will kill even a max HP, max Spadef. I believe even if it has Aqua Berry, Flamethrower still KOs it from full, which is nice. After a Dragon Dance, Mega Mane, even if it comes in and intimidates, will fall to the Wartirium Zed, I believe, if I remember my calcs correctly. Hopefully I can weaken things down so that Gyarados can win. Catch you in the battle, which will probably be coming out shortly after this, like usual. So catch you for that.